Survive, you're my queen from Boston. Survive, I'm your king from Boston. Survive, you're the queen. Yo, what's going down, everybody? It is Straight Outta Boston here, aka the King of Boston. Today we're back for episode 53 of the Utah Jazz Association here on NBA 2K13. You can see we enter the last game of the season, a game and a half back of Oklahoma City, so we have no shot at getting that number one seed. We faltered a little bit in the last month of the season. You can see we're only 2-4 in this month going into this final game against the New Orleans Hornets. So this is a game more for bragging rights than anything else. We are locked into the 2 seed. New Orleans is locked into the 5 seed. So there really isn't anything we can do to affect either of those positions, but this is a potential conference finals matchup. These are two teams that excelled during the regular season, faltered a little bit late. New Orleans was up there at the 3 seed for most of the year, even in the 2 seed for parts of it, ahead of Oklahoma City, but they struggled as well in the last month. So this is a battle of teams that are slipping into the playoffs a little bit and will need to improve if they want to make a finals run. So this is going to be the last regular season episode of the Utah Jazz Association for year 5. And you can see Derek Favors and Anthony Davis getting ready right there. Checking out the uniforms, you can see we got the green alternates for the Jazz and the yellow alternates for the New Orleans Hornets. Although, there will be Pelicans at the point of this game being played in 5 years or whatever. But either way, we'll just call them the Hornets for this episode to keep things simple. So you can see the records right there. We are playing for our 55th win. They're playing for their 52nd. And the tip is going to be won by Cody Zeller, the starting center for this team. Now, this is a team that we did have trade talks with at the midpoint of the season. They had a bit of a logjam at small forward. Jeff Green was not happy with the minutes he was getting. Otto Porter was taking some of those minutes, and I was really looking to get Otto Porter really for these last 2 seasons as a backup small forward, but we could not work out a deal with them. The salaries wouldn't really match up with our players. I didn't want to give up Anderson Terry or Jeff Withey, and without them, we really couldn't make the salaries match up. But Steph Curry had it going early on right here. And you can see he hits the mid-range right there. Curry was really creating his own shot today, not even just taking those spot-up threes. He was really creating mids off the dribble, getting into the lane at points. Anthony Davis with the put-back slam right there. We can take a look at what Anthony Davis might look like 5 years down the road from this current point in the NBA, because Anthony Davis does have franchise big potential. We all know that. We all have seen him play at Kentucky. He threw up a very nice rookie year. I think he only got 13-8, but he only played 28 minutes a game, so his per 36s were like 16-10. So, he had an effective rookie year. We'll see if he can continue his development and take it to the next level. Obviously, he'll have to put on some more weight if he does want to become a franchise big, but we'll see where that goes. Eric Gordon, another player that, if he stays healthy, could become a top 5 shooting guard in the NBA. He is very offensive-minded, does not play a whole lot of defense, but he can score with the best of them, quite frankly. Nolan Smith, though, with the nice right-handed layup after one of the worst seasons in NBA history during 2012. Nolan Smith has emerged nicely for this Hornets team. Caron Butler hitting the corner three, I've mentioned before. His shot has been getting better as the season goes on, so that's a good sign for the playoffs. Jamal Crawford coming up here, crossing Ben McLemore, then getting by Nolan Smith, dishing it to Hibbert for the slam. We'll take a look at a replay on this. Jay crossover, looking like the young Jay crossover. As you can see, he goes behind the back, shaking McLemore, and then does a little hezzy move around Nolan Smith, makes a nice extra pass to Roy Hibbert for the slam. Very impressive move by Jamal Crawford. I was like, oh, it's the old Jay Crawford when I did that. But either way, we're going to go into the second quarter on top by 11, 32-21. A nice lead so far. A great performance by the Jazz so far. It's an 11-point game. Still, Jeff Green gets the steal, makes a nice bounce pass to Jairus Bird. And Bird puts an error. It's not Jairus Bird. That's the guy from the Bills. What am I talking about? I don't know what his first name is. But here we can see they played a little lackadaisical defense. I gave it up to Caron Butler. Makes a nice behind-the-back pass to Withey, who finds Gary Harris for the two-pointer. And an effective play right there. Got to take advantage when the defense does not get back. I don't do that too often, but when I see a clear one like that, got to take advantage of it. So either way, you can see your score is going to be a 42-32 right here. Nolan Smith, top of the key, gives it to Ben McLemore, the former Utah Jazz, who dishes it off to Anthony Davis, and Davis puts it in with the left hand. Nice touch around the basket. Now it's back to a 6-point game. Curry looking for a screen. He's going to find one. Finds himself open for that long, too. This is what I'm talking about. He was really creating his own shot today. 7-7 from the field. Only 1-3 so far. A lot of twos. He's got 3 assists as well. Curry with the ball is going to give it out to Paul George for 3, and George knocks that one down. So George was really doing well as a spot-up shooter today. He really played that role in today's game. Curry doing a lot of the creating for the team. But Nolan Smith gets a rebound here, puts it back up, and scoops it in. So Nolan Smith has an impressive 8 points, 5 rebounds so far. Here's Jabari Bird. That's his name. And here's George Hill, I believe that is, who almost turns it over, but Gordon gets it back and puts it in with the right. So it's down to a 7-point game. Now still a 7-point game. Anderson Terry gives it to Gary Harris, trying to go to work on Eric Gordon. That is a pretty big mismatch, considering Gordon's really poor defense. But
Carl Landry puts that one in. Nice touch around the rim for him. It's back to a 7-point game, though. 51-44. Bird dishes it off to Eric Gordon down low. Gets the and one slam and a chance to cut the lead to four as we get near halftime. Now it's down to a 2-point game. Here comes George Hill with the ball. Dribbling up the court. Finds a wide open Eric Gordon in the corner for three. He misses it, but Cody Zeller is there for the putback, and it's 51-all. Now 53-51. It's a rebound for Jeff Withey. Outlet pass to Rajon Rondo, who's running the break. Lobs it up at Paul George with the crazy slam right there. And we take a 4-point lead. And that will take us into the half as we go up on top 55-51 as we enter halftime. Impressive performance by both teams in the first half, but it is really wide open at this point. So Cody Zeller trying to go by a speedy Roy Hibbert, sizes him up, and then just pulls up in his face. Dirty moves by Cody Zeller. And now 59-57, Steph Curry with the ball, trying to go to work on Nolan Smith. He gets the screen from Hibbert, comes around, pulls up from the elbow, and a nice shot right there by Steph Curry. Just what I talked about, creating his own shot today, just doing a phenomenal job. Here's Anthony Davis down low to Eric Gordon, who tries to cross over Rondo, who puts the lob up to Anthony Davis. Crazy play right there. 61-all is your score. And now Rondo with the ball, looking for Caron Butler coming around a screen. Butler for three. It's up, and it is good. Caron Butler with the second three of the game. Great showing out of him so far today. If he can hit two or three threes a game for us, I'd be very satisfied with that. He's still a pretty good defender for his age. Ben McLemore on the pull-up puts that one home, and that's going to take it down to a 1-point game. Now, after New Orleans takes the lead, it's 65-64. Jabari Bird with the ball. This is a two. Wilson Chandler, and Chandler puts that one home from the elbow, and they take a 3-point lead. Now still a 3-point game. Rondo with the ball. He's got a mismatch here. Cody Zeller on him, tries to size him up, take it into the paint. Up, gets bumped, but still puts it in. That's when the up and under really doesn't work, is when you get bumped like that. That's why it doesn't always work with smaller players like Rondo, but he has the finishing ability to put that one in. Jamal Crawford with the crazy contested three right there. We tie the game back up at 69. Big shot from Jay Crawford. And now Paul George, as time winding down the third quarter, he pulls up and he puts it in. Paul George, the crazy play at the end of the third quarter, gives us the lead back, 75-73. We will enter the fourth quarter with a 2-point lead. So now 77-75. George Hill with the ball down low to Trevor Lyles. Lyles is going to end up making the extra pass to Ben McLemore in the corner for three, and McLemore puts it home. 78-77. Now it's tied up back at 80 right here. Nolan Smith with the ball, trying to get into the paint on Paul George. Smith making some nice moves, puts up the leaning layup, misses, but once again, these tip slams are killing us from Anthony Davis and Cody Zeller, two young bigs. And, you know, they just have that athletic ability to really beat you on the boards. Hibbert is not really that athletic, especially at the age of 30. Favors a little bit more so, but I don't know, he just wasn't doing a good job today. So 2-point lead for the Hornets at this point. We're going to send Steph Curry around this screen. It's wide open for three. You know I'm going to take that. You know I'm going to make that. He's got a huge game going so far. It's 88-all at this point. Nolan Smith coming down the court. He's going to end up making the bounce pass to Wilson Chandler. Chandler puts that elbow shot home right there. And they take a 2-point lead. So we're going to try and go back to Curry right here. Steps back for three. It is good. Steph Curry with 39 points at this point. An incredible performance so far. He's still got 4 minutes to play. It's a 1-point game. Jazz on top. Nolan Smith with the ball. Really tried to go to work on Steph Curry. Looks like he's got a man coming around a screen. It's Eric Gordon on the lob. And Gordon slams it home. They retake the lead. Now it's 96-91. Look at Anthony Davis running the break a little bit. Dishes it to Cody Zeller, and Zeller's going to knock down that 18-footer. They take a 7-point lead right here. So we're going to try and go quick. Steph Curry with the ball. We got to go to him. He's got Eric Gordon covering him. That's too big of a mismatch. He gets some space and hits the three. An incredible performance by Stephen Curry so far. He's got 34 points at this point. I was mistaken on his point total earlier. I think I said 36 instead of 26. Eric Gordon, though, for three. He knocks that one home. You know he's got that fourth quarter sig skill. We're going to try and go right back to Curry. In your face. It is not going to go. Favors on the boards. And one. Derek Favors coming up clutch. And it's down to a 3-point game. We get the rebound here. Rondo pushing the ball. Do we go for a three? Do we go for a quick two? In the lane. Floater. No good. Eric Gordon on the rebound. We have to foul him. He would go to the free throw line and make two. We would hit another three, so now they're going to come back. It's a 2-point game. They give it to Nolan Smith. We quickly foul, and he has to just make one or two of these if he wants his team to come out on top. He misses both, though. We give it to Paul George. Full court shot is no good, and yes, I should have called the timeout there. I don't know what I was thinking. It just didn't cross my mind to call timeout. That was my fault. We could have had a shot to win that, but it is what it is. Like I said, this game really didn't matter. So we finished the regular season 54-28, I believe. Well, yeah, 54-28. The Hornets improved to 52-30. So this could be a conference finals matchup. We'll see what happens in the near future. The West is really top heavy this year. We'll see who can come out on top come playoff time. But this could have been a very nice preview. An incredible game. Great performance on both sides. We end up taking the L. Anthony Davis is your player of the game. Like I talked about earlier, he kind of has filled out that potential in this association that we've all thought of when he was drafted number one overall just 2 years, or well, really only a year ago. But anyway, you can see some of his highlights. He was really showing off his athleticism, getting those tip slams, catching those oops. You can see here's one right here where he ends up, I don't know what happened actually, but Anthony Davis hitting the mid-range right there. He finishes with 20 points, 14 rebounds, an assist and a steal. And you can see the team stats right here. You know, they beat us in a lot of team categories, and oftentimes, even when in a close game like this, the team that dominates these categories ends up winning. So Steph Curry drops 40. Only two other players on double figures, a little bit concerning. Rondo dropped 8, though, but we need more production from our bench. Gordon and Davis combined for 43 points, a nice performance out of them. Anyway, it's going to wrap up this video, so I thank you guys for watching. Hope you did enjoy, and just I'm out.